Mood. The champions were in town, but Newcastle were top of the table. Kevin Keegan would love it if he could beat Alex Ferguson. And KK's entertainers were at their entertaining best. Hawaii 5-0.
Well, there was a time when it was often said about Manchester United that they could only play a certain way, but Alex Ferguson has developed the tactical flexibility within his talented squad. We might see signs of that again in this match, as they're under pressure here from the powerful running of Ginola. The shot from Ferdinand and a deflection that would have left Schmeichel flat-footed, but it's gone wide.
Well, he didn't move, Peter Schmeichel. It's a great block from Dennis Irwin in the end. Ginola did everything right. Really good block. The keeper's beaten. You don't often see Peter Schmeichel just stand there.
Matt Shearer going up well. Peacock! The goal is given, and Manchester United are very angry about it.
I'd like to see that one again. I thought Irwin got there, Martin, I have to be honest. The Lines has got the best view in the ground, no doubt about that.
Well, you can see that Schmeichel has come across to lead the debate.
We'll get a look at it from here. Shearer wins the first header, Peacock the second as it drops. Well, I don't think that's over. I think it's impossible for the linesman to give 100% from where he's standing. With Dennis Irwin's left foot where it is. Again, you see the two. Shearer does ever so well there. Peacock's header's half blocked, and as it's rolling, it's rolling. Oh dear. It looks over, doesn't it?
It does there. And it's in behind Darren Peacock, and it's Poborski who's popped up in the centre. And, well, one player from the Czech Republic in contact with another, and Poborski doesn't get the penalty that he believes he deserves.
Well, it's the conditions again, spins away, they get a little bit of confusion here, goalkeeper goes to the ground. You see the left, but look what he makes of it. I think that might well have influenced the referee. Well, he thought it was.
Ginola has been prominent in it.
Prominent indeed. It's a classic goal from David Ginola. It's 2-0 to Newcastle.
What a magnificent strike. Sheer quality, sheer class. The way it's played into him. I think Gary Neal was a little bit on the wrong side. In fact, he is. He's a bit outside Ginola. You can see the way he was just holding it. He could feel it. He immediately turned inside. He didn't look at the goal. He doesn't need to. He don't move. He sets it off at this side. It's past Peter Schmeichel. It's arcing into the top corner. It's a wonderful goal. There you go. Look how much space Gary Neville's given him, Martin. And from there, that is absolute class. Take a bow, son. Wonderful.
Shearer. Into play. He's had an attempt now.
I tell you what, if I'm admiring Ginola, that one was even better, I think. It was certainly struck with far more power. Schmeichel saw it. It was on his side, but he couldn't get near it. I mean, this is hit with such pace and ferocity.
Cantona did well to find Becker. Well, Sonicek save from Poborski. Cantona! And the goalkeeper's finally got it, and more evidence you feel that this day is going to go Newcastle's way.
Well, Sonicek and then either Watson or Peacock, who really got back on the line, and really, what an important decision that is for the defender. Cantona must have felt sure he'd got his side back in the game.
Ginola. Oh, they've melted away from Peter Beardsley of Manchester United. Beardsley's pass, as the ball dropped then for the flying Ferdinand, he really thought it was going to be 3-0.
Well, I'm not saying he should score, but Les will know he should hit the target. He's got a great position, absolute great position for a striker. And even though the goalkeeper's flying at him, the ball is so good from Peter Beardsley. That's just begging to be put in the net. And certainly begging to hit the target.
Beardsley. gets it back from Lee. He finds Ferdinand. Here's Shearer. Not the favourite of the Manchester United fans.
Ferdinand off the bar and in! It is 3-0 now!
And that's the most difficult header. And that is Shearer. Look at Shearer. That is game set and match. He's already a Manchester United fan. But they're giving him sick when he had the ball in that corner there. But look at the way, yet again, from... Well, how does he work the ball in from there? I mean, Stanley Matthews at his best couldn't do that. Centre-forward, but somehow he fashions out across a real quality, and that is a soaring header from Ferdinand. He gives the goalkeeper absolutely no chance, back across from where it came from, underside of the bar, and this time Kerry can celebrate. This time Les doesn't let him down.
Scholes, the last Englishman to be voted to that prestigious position was certain Kevin Keegan. Great vision from Shearer. Beardsley. Oh, and it's another one now. Yes, Shearer, of course. The script is complete for Newcastle United.
And it started and finished with that man there, Alan Shearer. He was available to receive the ball through. Was mentioned he hadn't scored 2 minutes later. Well, that's a put right. Same team, same scoreline. Different way around.
Pallister bringing it away. Brilliant. Brilliant. Beardsley. Yeah. Ginola, who's been really in tune with the special requirements of this game right from the start. It's David Batty!
Well, that deserved a goal. It deserved a goal for the genius on the near side of David Ginola, who skipped past Gary Neville quite beautifully. And it deserved a goal for the wonderful awareness of Les Ferdinand with a lovely cushion header. And it deserved a goal for Batty's one. Look at this, watch him come into the picture. And he's only just out.
Ginola. Beardsley. Well, there could be a fifth in the offing. Lee. On a day when Newcastle would have taken 1-0. Here they are, looking for number five. With Philippe Albert. To really pinch yourself to believe that it's happened.
Hey, you don't have to pinch anyone in this ground that's watching it. All these Newcastle supporters know what's happening. The ones who are stunned are in the far corner, the Manchester United supporters.
What a day to remember from Newcastle United. Manchester United's biggest defeat for 12 years, the last unbeaten record in this season's Premiership, well and truly ended. Newcastle's first ever Premiership win over the club, which ruined their Championship ambitions last season. And to top it off, of course, it takes them emphatically back to the top of the league.